This is the year I'm getting into shape. Seriously, you know. Or soon, but not yet, but soon. I'm working towards. And you know, honestly, there's a lot of reasons for getting into shape. Like, seriously, I don't think you should just stand and sweat. I'm pretty sure. I think this might be wrong. Is there a doctor in the house? I'm not. That can't be right, everybody. But a lot of reasons is because, honestly, I can't compete with the girls. In like summertime, I stay home in the summer. That is it. Thin girls, you get the summer. That's yours. Live it up for 4 months. Have fun. All right. Because I see you out there in your little tops, your little half shirt. I get it. Go out there. Get out there and metabolize or whatever it is you do. I'm not a scientist. But go. I love it. I see you. See, I wait until, like, the winter. You know, the minute it gets cold, I make my move. That's what I do. Put a little cardigan on. Boom. I'm out the door. Do you understand what I'm saying? And this is it. I get it. Because, you know, at that point, when it gets cold, the thin girls, you know, you got to put your shirts back on, you know. And then what are you going to do? Talk? Anyhow. Oh. I should have told, I'm a bit biased. I should have mentioned off the top. I do have a disclaimer for my show that I should have mentioned. Everyone, the fact that I'm a big woman has not affected my ability to judge other people. It hasn't at all, at all. Let's judge, shall we? But no, actually, to be honest with you, I did lose a little bit of weight recently, but then I found it again. What the fuck, seriously? It was in the fridge. Who puts it there? Every time I'm like, son of a bitch, there it is. Oh. I live alone. I don't know how that happens. But the one thing, you know, you always have one of those moments, like a moment of clarity where you realize, no, this is it. This is it. Time to get into shape. I did a show, a corporate show, all right, a couple months ago. And I didn't know who the company was. I just show up, you know, to do my business. And I realized that everyone's really casual. They're all like in like workout wear, sweatpants and stuff. I'm like, uh-oh, what's going on? So I find out that me, this woman you see standing before you, I'm performing for the people of a fitness club. Yeah, that me. I had a moment where I was like, is this an intervention? Seriously, is this, are my parents here? Oh my God, seriously? Are you, lovely people, very good people. They wouldn't give me my check until I did 2 laps, but whatever, that's fine. No, and they're nice. They gave me a free membership to their club, you know what I mean? I'm like, that's very nice. So I go and to join up at this little fitness place. So I go in and I just wanna say hi and look around, you know, get my little card and stuff. But the first thing they do at this gym is I walk in and they give me a body fat test, the first thing they do, which is not the greatest way to greet people, do you know what I'm saying? That's not really, and it's not fair either because I didn't get a chance to study or prepare for my body fat test. Not fair. But don't worry, everyone, I still passed. But this is something you should know. 50% on a body fat test is not a good score. That's not a good score. You know, I was like, oh, I don't have to write the exam. No, everybody. At 50% body fat, seriously, I think that makes me cream. I think that technically makes me cream, doesn't it? I'm dying alone, but I'm delicious with coffee. Shut your face. Seriously? Seriously? Yeah. Just looking for my coffee, mate. So lonely. Anyway, back to happy. No, God bless. Now, they also, at this gym, they gave me a personal trainer. I had to carry her around. It was so strange. Little fabulous little human person. And she's very small, like this little tiny thing there. And she's screaming at me all the time. I'm like, really? I could kill you with one hand, little girl. Keep talking. So small. Like, there are those moments sometimes that I look at her and I think, how are we the same species? Do you know what I mean? We're both girls. I have no idea how her body works. I have no idea. Her hips are that wide. Do you see this? Over there. And I know this for sure because I measured her. You know, she was too weak to get away. So hungry. Poor thing, she kept crying. I can pull her back. It was fun. But this is my question for the world and earth and science. If your hips are this narrow, how do you have internal organs? Seriously, what is going on inside your body? Are they stacked up like pancakes? What is happening in there? Oh, pancakes. Okay, no. Now is the time for focus. Pancakes later. But anyway, now this little girl, she sends me to my doctor because I don't know if you guys have heard of this before, but there's this new way to lose weight. It's called eating less and exercising. Have you heard about that? That sounds like bullshit to me. It really does. I need more proof, you know? So I go in to this doctor, and God bless, I've known my doctor forever, all right? Like, I've been her patient for 15 years, so we're pretty comfortable now. I can ask her anything, you know? And every year, you know, she wants to talk about the weight loss, and she's trying to keep me motivated, God bless. So she says to me, Deborah, you know what you need? You need like a mantra that you tell yourself. So she says to me, live like you're dying tomorrow. Now, that's a beautiful sentiment. Live like there's one day left on earth. It's beautiful. But you can't say that to a big woman on a diet. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because if I am dying tomorrow, who gives a fuck about tonight? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding?